In this lesson, we will cover several important aspects of Chiari, including the different definitions of Chiari, the anatomy of Chiari, a brief history of Chiari, and how the concept of Chiari is evolving. Since you are taking this course, it is likely that either you or someone you care about has been affected by Chiari. It is also likely that before this happened, you had never heard of Chiari, had any idea what it is, or even how to pronounce it. That's okay. You're not alone in this regard, and that's why we're here, specifically to learn about Chiari. The first thing to understand is that Chiari can mean different things to different people. To a patient, Chiari is a difficult to understand disease with many symptoms and manifestations. To a neurosurgeon, Chiari is a structural defect to be corrected with surgery. To an uninformed physician, Chiari might be considered a harmless variant from normal and nothing to worry about. To a family member, Chiari is often an invisible affliction hurting their loved one. Now, let's turn our attention to how Chiari is defined. Unfortunately, Chiari is not always easy to define, even in medical terms. This is because the definition of Chiari is evolving, both as technology improves and as we learn more about it. However, for the purposes of this lesson, understanding what Chiari is will first require deciphering some medical jargon and learning a little bit about human anatomy. Let's start by looking at what Chiari is in general terms. Chiari is a serious, often chronic neurological disorder that involves abnormalities of the craniovertebral junction and compression of the brain and spinal cord. So what does this mean? Let's break it down. First, chronic means that for some patients, the effects of Chiari are long-lasting, and Chiari is something they will deal with for their entire life. Second, the term neurological refers to the nervous system, which is comprised of the brain, spinal cord, and the many nerve fibers which run through our body. Next, Chiari is often referred to as a disorder because it is not a disease in the sense of a virus or bacterial infection. The craniovertebral junction is where the skull or cranium meets the spine. Internally, the junction is also where the brainstem becomes the spinal cord, and in Chiari, where the herniated cerebellar tonsils are located. And finally, abnormalities, in this case, refers to anatomical structures which aren't normal. So in broad terms, Chiari patients have unusual anatomy in the region where the skull meets the spine, which then causes compression or squeezing of the cerebellum brainstem and spinal tissue inside. It is said a picture is worth a thousand words, so let's look at a simple picture of what Chiari anatomy is. Here we see that in an average or healthy person, the bottom part of the brain, called the cerebellum, is completely contained in the skull. However, in a person with Chiari, the very bottom of the cerebellum, known as the tonsils, are protruding out of the skull through the opening where the brain meets the spinal cord. Like a cork being jammed into a wine bottle, this protrusion then squeezes or compresses these parts together. Unfortunately, there's more. In the human body, the brain and spinal cord are bathed in a clear liquid called cerebrospinal fluid, or CSF. This fluid plays a vital role in that it supports the weight of the brain, acts as a shock absorber, delivers vital nutrients to the central nervous system, and removes waste products. With every heartbeat, blood is pumped into the brain, which then pushes CSF out of the brain and into the spinal area and back again. In a Chiari patient, this natural sloshing of CSF from brain to spine and back is blocked and disrupted by the protruding cerebellar tonsils. The effects of this are not clearly understood, but are a major focus of Chiari research. So at its core, Chiari is about unusual anatomy. Chiari patients tend to have skulls, spines, and brains which are not like the average person's. Now that we've gone over what Chiari is in general and learned a little bit about the anatomy of Chiari, let's look at the history of Chiari. Chiari, like many medical diseases and disorders, was named after the person who first described it, which in this case was Hans Chiari, an Austrian pathologist. In 1891, more than 130 years ago, Chiari published a paper describing the case of a 17-year-old woman in whom he observed, after she died from typhoid fever, an elongation of the cerebellar tonsils. Later, he published on more cases and classified his observations of the malformations into several types, which serve as the basis for the classic definition of Chiari. The most common are Chiari 1, where the cerebellar tonsils are herniated through the opening in the bottom of the skull. Chiari 1 is the focus of this course. Chiari 2, where additional brain structures, such as the brainstem or main body of the cerebellum, are also herniated. Today, most people use Chiari 2 to refer to cases that coincide with spina bifida. Although these definitions appear simple at first, the history of Chiari, especially for Chiari 1, is full of confusion and disagreement. A few years after Chiari published his paper, Julius Arnold published his observations of malformations in newborns, similar to Chiari's type 2. And in the early 1900s, people started using the term Arnold-Chiari. Some people used this only for type 2, while others referred to all cases as Arnold-Chiari. Adding to the confusion, over the years, other names and terms have been introduced in the literature in reference to Chiari. But for our purposes, when we refer to Chiari, we mean Chiari malformation type 1. It's important to keep in mind that during these early years, and the decades that followed, there was no medical imaging available to look at people's brains. So while Chiari had been identified, until the introduction of MRIs in the 1980s, it was very difficult to diagnose. However, MRIs changed everything. For the first time, doctors could get a detailed picture of a patient's skull and brain, which led to the modern, or clinical definition of Chiari based on tonsillar position. This technological, medical, and scientific progression has led to a more detailed clinical definition of Chiari. Let's dive into what this means. Tonsillar position refers to how far the tip of the cerebellar tonsils are located below the opening at the bottom of the skull, known as the foramen magnum. To understand how tonsillar position is measured, it's important to understand that an MRI creates a complete, three-dimensional representation of the brain and skull, which are then viewed in individual slices. To measure tonsillar position, first we select what is called the mid-sagittal slice of the MRI, which basically splits the head in half, running from the nose to the back of the head. Next, in this video, an imaginary line is drawn across the skull opening. This is known as the McCrae line. Finally, another line is drawn perpendicular to this one, down to the tip of the cerebellar tonsil. The length of this line, in millimeters, represents the tonsillar position. Now that they were able to quantify Chiari malformations, researchers started studying them in a different way. In 1986, Barkovich and a team published a study which measured the tonsillar position of 25 patients, with what they determined to be clear signs and symptoms of Chiari, and compared them to 200 healthy people. They found that the tonsillar position of the two groups overlapped between 3 to 5 millimeters. In other words, the healthy people had tonsillar positions from above the McCrae line to 5 millimeters below, and the Chiari patients had tonsillar positions of at least 3 millimeters below the McCrae line. From this, the radiological definition, meaning based on imaging of Chiari, emerged as tonsillar herniation of at least 3 to 5 millimeters. Over time, this evolved to 5 millimeters and became known as the 5 millimeter rule. However, as time went on and MRIs became more prevalent, it became clear there were some problems with the 5 millimeter rule. This ultimately led to the evolution of the definition of Chiari. The first problem that came to light was that tonsillar position is not strongly related to symptom severity. In 1999, Thomas Millerat and colleagues published a landmark paper which provided a detailed report on over 300 Chiari patients. They found that tonsillar position was not related to symptom severity. They also identified patients with clear indications of Chiari who had less than 3 millimeters of herniation. The second problem that emerged is that as MRIs became more and more common, it became clear that a certain number of people meet the 5mm MRI definition of Chiari, but do not have any symptoms. In fact, large studies have shown that symptomatic Chiari is the exception, not the rule. Specifically, 1-2% of the adult population and up to 3% of kids have been found to have tonsillar position greater than 5mm, yet only about 0.1% of people have symptomatic Chiari. Therefore, there are many, many more people without symptoms than with. It has become clear that tonsillar position varies across the population, much like height and weight do. In addition, studies have shown that tonsillar position, even in healthy people, is not fixed, but rather varies over time. All of this results in confusion about what Chiari actually is. While some people use the term Chiari to refer to anyone with tonsillar herniation of 5 millimeters or more, others reserve the term Chiari to only refer to people who are symptomatic. Because of these issues, many medical experts have now begun to question the 5 millimeter rule. However, finding a new measure of Chiari has proven elusive. So although it is not perfect, tonsillar position is still the best marker for symptomatic Chiari available. But it is important to keep in mind that it is not the whole story. To summarize, Chiari can mean different things to different people. Chiari is a serious, often chronic, neurological disorder that involves compression of the cerebellum, brainstem, and spinal cord. In Chiari patients, the cerebellar tonsils protrude or herniate out of the skull. The current definition of Chiari is based on measuring tonsillar position on MRI. However, this is not a great definition, and many experts are looking for a better one.